In 1881, Pizarro decided to make two very large pictures of rural life, and it was a hard decision for him because he wasn't really comfortable making big pictures. He liked to work in a smaller arena, so there wouldn't be so much risk in making things. And so he started to make a very large picture that dealt with apple picking. That was one of the two pictures. Hired models, and he posed them, and he did this, and he did that, and he never really liked it. And in 1884, 3 years later, he was still struggling with this picture when he met a young artist named Georges Seurat. Then he finally went in 1885, the next year, to Seurat's studio to see him working on a very large picture called the Grand Jatte, which we all know because it's been since 1926 in the Art Institute of Chicago and is one of the greatest paintings in the history of Western art. Having looked at the Grand Jatte, having criticized the Grand Jatte, and having forced Seurat to repaint the Grand Jatte, and he too repainted his earlier apple pickers. And the two pictures hung in the same room in the final exhibition of 1886. When you look at the apple pickers, you have to think of rural workers who don't have to work too hard, unlike Millet's workers, and who in some ways could aspire to the kind of leisure that the petit bourgeois people in Paris in the Grand Jatte succeed in enjoying so well on a beautiful day. And it's important for all of us to think that this sort of old impressionist was actually one of the most vital young painters in the late 1880s, and that he allowed himself to be influenced and affected deeply by young artists. And he allowed a young artist to give him the courage and the guts to finish something that he'd started 6 years earlier.